guys, it's Bridget. Being goal-oriented and organized is super important to me, and never is it more important than at the start of a new year. I know, we're a little late for the new year, but it's really never too late to get started. At the end of each year, I don't make a New Year's resolution for the new one. Instead, I make a list of my goals and dreams. I create a vision board and write down the steps for achieving my goals. And today, I'm going to show you how I do this, so you can do the same. You may say to yourself, why do I need to do this? I know what I want, it's all in my head, why do I have to turn it into a craft project? Good question, because having a visual of your hopes and dreams can keep you focused and motivated. A visual aid to remind yourself every day of what you want in life will keep you on track and help make all your dreams come true. So now you're probably saying to yourself, Bridget, please show me the way to achieve all of my goals. So without further ado, here we go. If you're like me, you don't just have one goal or one area in your life that you want to work on, but several things. And with a whole year ahead of us, there's no reason we can't take on several goals. So get out a paper or a pen or start typing and take a few minutes to decide what is important to you this year. What areas in your life do you want to work on? Write these down. Think about all the aspects of your life. You'll probably find that you have different categories for goals, like home, family, work, etc. Here are my categories. First, personal, family, career, and adventure. Don't feel like you have to use these. You can make yours unique to you. This is your personal board of dreams. There's no right or wrong way. So let me break these down. And you should break yours down too. Personal. These are goals that just involve me. One of my goals is to stay positive. I'm a pretty positive person naturally, but some days are harder than others. Staying positive is a daily battle and needs constant attention. Health. What can I do to be healthier this year? For one, I need to start drinking more water. And I thought I would like to try some meditation this year. Stay in shape. I'm already in pretty good shape, but as we all know, working out regularly and eating somewhat healthy is a constant struggle. So I want to continue on my workout routine, possibly add some yoga. I would love to get back into trapeze. Sometimes you need to add goals that you already achieved but want to work on maintaining. Next is family. These are goals that revolve around my relationship and for me trying to start a family. So planning my wedding is top of my priorities this year. I'm not going into any details on my board because I would need a million of these boards, but I have a separate board and a Pinterest page and all that kind of stuff with all my wedding specifics. And you can do that too if there's one area you really want to laser in on. Baby, we've been trying to start a family, so what can I do to make that happen this year? Maybe another round of fertility treatments, fertility yoga, supplements, eating healthy, acupuncture. Let's just say I'll be trying a lot of new things to try and make it happen. Career. I'm currently writing a book, so my goal is to finish writing my book this year. 1,000 words a day, have people proofread it, find a literary agent. Producing. I have a few producing projects in the works, and I'm hoping that I'll be able to make some of them happen this year. Ghost tours. I absolutely love giving ghost tours, and I've done a few of these in the past, and I would like to start working on them more regularly. Maybe with the Queen Mary, the Stanley Hotel, Mansfield Reformatory, Eastern State, and of course, my YouTube channel. This is a new adventure for me this year, and I hope to have a lot of fun with it. My last category is adventure. This includes a lot of things like travel and ghost hunting, trying new foods and restaurants, just adding fun and adventure to life. Once I have my categories and a few things that I want out of each of them, now I can begin looking for things that represent that to me. It can be pictures, a word, a phrase, anything that makes you think of that particular goal. You can thumb through magazines, or look at images online. Once you have a few images for each of the things you want in life, begin to cut them out of the magazine or print them off your computer. Here's a tip. I like to print mine on sticker paper. Then I don't need glue sticks. You can make this vision board as big and visual or as simple and discreet as you want. It can be on any color paper that inspires you, but you have to promise, no matter what size or color, to look at it often. Remind yourself of what you want to achieve. So, grab your board, and let's get started. There! When it's all done, I have a complete visual of all the things I want to work on, and it's a positive reminder of all the things I can bring into my life throughout the year. Another tip, this is a fun project to do with friends. You can share ideas and inspire each other. You can stop here, but I usually take it one step further and I make a list of things I need to do to reach each one of these goals. After you're done, you should have all of your goals spelled out and a clear path on how to make them happen. Don't worry if you get a little off track, just revisit your board and reset yourself. And feel free to add to it or modify it if you feel it needs to be. I always like to leave some extra space, as you can see, for things that might pop up later on. We can't always predict where life is going to take us, so stay positive, flexible, and make adjustments when needed. Let this board be your personal guide to life. Dream big and plan ahead.